First time we're seeing Ayodhya Kanda of Shri Ramcharitmanas of Goswami Tulsidas Ji, and in particular Ram Bharat Milap. On the 6 days that preceded today, we saw all the vighna, obstacles that Bharat faced on his journey from Ayodhya to Chitrakoot, where Bhagwan Shri Ram was staying. And if you missed out those 6 days, well, what to tell you? Jo hua so hua. What is gone is gone. But today we see the meeting of that great devotee of Bhagwan Shri Ram. He is considered as the greatest bhakta of the Lord. He's great, considered as saint. He's considered as the incarnation of the love of Bhagwan. He's considered as the ideal brother, ideal aspirant, seeker, sadhak, anything you can think about. Bharat is considered to be the ideal, the benchmark for anybody. In fact, Tulsidas Ji writes in a very nice verse here, you know. He says, if Bharat was not born, see, this is after 232. Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram.
होत जग जन्म भरत को
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
सकल धर्म धुर धर नि भरत को
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
कवि कुल आगम भरत गुण गाथा जानै तुम बिनु रघुनाथ
श्री राम जय राम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
जय रघुराम Dasharath Ram
Syamara Ramachandra ki jai
If Bharat was not born in the world, how would we have known the greatness of Ram? Tulsidas Ji writes. Ko janai tum binu Raghunatha. Without you, Bharat, the poets write. If Bharat was not born, we would not have known the greatness of Ram. In other words, when the Lord is taking an incarnation, avatar, the Lord also manifests the things around Him so that we'll come to, through those things, come to know the Lord. And so, if Bharat was not born, we would have never known the greatness of the Lord. That is the Tulsidas Ji, right? How great is this Bharat? It is through Him we know the greatness of Bhagwan. Then, we would not have known what is dharma also. Because it was Bharat who stood up for dharma. Who stood up for what is right. See, dharma is in the final analysis, what is the right thing to do. See, right thing was not for him to go and take the throne of Ayodhya. Even though the guru said, the father said, the mother requested everybody, take the throne. No. Sometimes things may appear to be right based on tradition, based on law, based on conventions and all whatever you have, and based on advice even of wise people. But the world is a changing world. The world is changing from moment to moment. And what may seem right today, what may seem correct today, tomorrow, it may not be the right course of action. And since circumstances change every moment, you cannot have sweeping and blanket rules. That is why for every rule there is an exception. Because no rule can be absolute. Because there is only one absolute thing in the universe. Now, don't use this to go and break every rule now. Eh? But Bharat realized that the advice of everybody and the tradition and everything that preceded did not sit well with his heart. And so, he stood up and followed his heart, which told him that he should go to the forest and bring Bhagavan Sri Ram. And in this case, that is the dharmic thing to do. And so, through Bharat's actions also, we see dharma upheld to the fullest. So otherwise, who would have upheld dharma? They say, I got the kingdom. Who gone, gone. I get the kingdom, so I good. That is what people do. They don't care about anybody else or care about dharma and righteousness or any such thing. So, if Bharat was not born, how we would have known about dharma? Where would we have seen an individual who is going to uphold dharma and so set the benchmark to the extent that Bharat had done? The very difficult thing, you see. Now, Bharat comes down. He's getting closer to the Prabhu Sri Ram. But then some thought comes to his mind. Tulsidashi tells just before 233. Shri Ram Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Shri Ram Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. राम लखन सिय सुनि ममनाउ
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
उठी जनि अनत जाहि तजिठाउ Siyavar Ramachandra ki jai. Ram Lakhan Sita suni mama now. Suppose, a thought came to his mind. Suppose Ram, Lakshman, Sita, they hear that I am coming. Somebody gives them the news that I am coming. And Bhagwan Sri Ram doesn't want to meet me. And suppose he leaves that place and runs away. Bharat thinks. Now, this thing is called a duvidha. And so why is it not a sixth the obstacle? Duvidha. Duvidha means doubt. Samshaya in Sanskrit. Doubt. So some people when they read, they say, this is another obstacle has come to his mind. No doubt has come. But duvidha is an obstacle that is there from the beginning of the sadhak's life to the end. In the last moment, have you seen yourself in meditation? In last moment also, you're trying to merge with Bhagwan. And that time you're thinking, what if I go into samadhi and don't get up for 6,000 years? Duvidha. Doubt is there. Because you read stories in Ramayana, Gita, and what do you call it? Mahabharata and all. Valmiki ji went there for 10,000 years. So those type of things come in mind. The second thing is, the five vigna, pancha vigna, which we saw on the previous day, five obstacles, they are things that come from the environment. Obstacles from inside, they are countless, numerous. And the whole journey of sadhana is to rid oneself of those obstacles. But Bharat quickly checks himself. And see, a sadhak is able to do this. The mind will throw up all sorts of duvidas, all sorts of samshaya. In Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan Sri Krishna says, those who cannot deal with the samshayas of the mind, the doubts of the mind, samshaya atma vinashyati, he says. Such people, they're as good as dead. We have to be able to deal with all the obstacles that arise in our mind. Outer obstacles, when we do sadhana, they will take care, the guru will take care, Bhagwan will take care, and previous sadhana will see to it that the outer obstacles are removed. Inner obstacles, require observation of the mind, sakshi bhav, and at earlier stages also we can preoccupy the mind with other things. When doubts come in the mind, that time chant the name of God, chant stuti, chant Hanuman Chalisa, all those sort of things. Here, as soon as the doubt came in his mind, Tulsidasji puts these words through Bharat's mouth. Shri Ram Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram.
जो परिहर हे मलिन मन जानी जो सन्मान ही सेवक मानी मोरे शरण राम ही की पनही सुस्वामी दोस सब जन ही हेरति मन हुमा तो कृत खोरी चलत भगति बल धीरज थोरी जय रघुराम जय सीताराम जय सीताराम
जो परिहरि मलिन मनु जानी इवन इफ ही थिंक्स मी टू बी अ वायलेंट विकेड पर्सन विद इविल डिजाइन इवन भगवान थिंक्स दैट ऑफ मी जो सनमान ही सेवक मानी एंड इफ ही थिंक्स दैट आई एम नॉट हिज सेवक स्टिल लेट हिम थिंक More saran Ram hi kippan hi. I have taken a vow. I am going to Ram no matter what he thinks about me. I am going to the Lord. And Rama su swami dosa sab janahi. And Ram is a most wonderful Ram. He will never think, it's a Bharat immediately. He will never think anything bad about me. He will, and even if he thinks, he will forgive me immediately. Those two things. So first of all, he would not think. And if by chance he thinks, immediately he will forgive me also. Bharat is very, very clear in his mind. So that type of Shraddha, this is called a Shraddha. Usko kya kehte hai? Shraddha. Shraddhavan labhate jnanam, Bhagavan Sri Krishna says in Gita. For the one who has this Shraddha, he'll get the absolute knowledge. It means he'll reach God. He'll reach the absolute self. Shraddhavan labhate jnanam. So, Bharat has absolute Shraddha. So what get rid of all duvidas? Shraddha. That is the grease. All duvidas slide away as though. So, the moment the thought came, the Shraddha sends it. Dekhi Bharat karat sochu sanehu. Seeing how agitated, how miserable Bharat's mind was, how much of sorrow he was going through, and how much love he had at the same time. Bha nishad tehi samaya videhu. Nishad, who was with Bharat, and this is a constant thought throughout the Ramayana. That, and I told on the previous day also, the one who holds on to the feet of the devotee, that one reaches before the devotee himself. Nishad, Tulsidasji writes here, Nishad, who is Guha, Nishad lost body consciousness looking at Bharat. He went into Samadhi. Nobody else has gone into Samadhi yet. Nishad has gone into Samadhi. Tulsidasji. Samaya? Bidehu. Bidehu means he lost his body consciousness. Just being in the presence of Bharat and seeing Bharat's love for Bhagwan Shri Ram. But Bharat continued. Pherati manahu matu krita khori. On the one hand, his mind torn by the thought of the wicked thing which his mother had done. And on the other hand, chalata bhagati baladhiraja dhori. And his strong devotion like a bull, Tulsidasji writes. His devotion like a bull pulling him towards Bhagwan Shri Ram. And the evil of his, what his mother had done, that thing, pulling his mind the other way, and see his mind going on too, right, ashamed. And then his devotion for Bhagavan Shri Ram. And Dhiraj means his bravery, fortitude. He continues on to meet this Bhagavan Shri Ram. And resolving in his mind that whatever the Lord thinks, I am still going to go. On the way, he saw the footprints of Bhagavan Shri Ram. Guha turned up, climbed up a hill and said, in the distance, I see the trees of Bhagavan Shri Ram's ashram. Bharat bows down to the ground, takes up the dust from the footprints of Bhagavan Shri Ram and puts on his head and prostrate to those trees from the distance also. Tulsidas described how the journey should not only be long and arduous, but it should also be enjoyable. Huh? This is the journey of devotion, enjoyable at the same time. Shri Ram Jaya Ram, Jaya Jaya Ram, Shri Ram Jaya Ram,
Jaya Jaya Ram,
Shri Ram Jaya Ram, Jaya Jaya Ram.
Harshini Rakhi Ram Pad Ankar
Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram
Manahu Paras Payu Urankar
Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram
Raj Sir Dhari Hiya Nayan Nilavahi
Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram
Raghuvar Milan Saris Sukh Pavahi
Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram
Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram
Shri Ram Jai
Harashini Rakhi Ram Pada Anka, and he saw the footprints of Bhagavan Shri Ram. And Manahu Parasa Paya Uranka. He felt, as Tulsidas described, he felt like when a Ranka, Ranka means a beggar, pauper beggar, like that. When a beggar finds the Paras money, you know, Paras money is the touchstone. You take the Paras money and you touch any metal, it turns into gold. So when the beggar finds that Paras money, like that feeling which he has, that's how Bharat felt on finding the footprints of Bhagavan Shri Ram, taking the dust and putting it on his head and his eyes. Raghuvara Milana Sarisa Sukha Pavahi. It is like, it was like meeting the Lord himself, just to see the Lord's footprint. And Tulsidashi gives a most wonderful doha. I'll tell you something before I tell this doha. You know, many times we ask about the symbolism in Ramayana. The symbolism of Ramayana. Some people call it the mysticism of Ramayana. But you don't have to make it up. You know, many times people make it up. I keep hearing all the time. People make up the symbolism or the mysticism. But we don't have to. Tulsidas ji himself has given the mysticism or the symbolism of Ramayana. See in this verse, I'll show you. It's Doha.
Amiya mandaru birahu Bharat payodhi gambiro Ram Bharat payodhi gambir Mati pragate usar sadhu hita Kripa sindhu raghubir siya Var Ram Chandra ki jai sharanam Umapati Mahadev ki jai Pavan Sut Hanuman ki jai Bolo bhai sab santan ki jai सियावर रामचंद्र की जय शरणम।
Okay, so see the symbolism. We don't have to go far to see that Jilam is giving us. You know, in Mahabharata, not Mahabharata, Bhagavad Puran, all the devatas went and they churned the ocean. And when they churned the ocean, the nectar came out. Amrit. Amrit means that by which you can get everlasting life. So that Amrit came out. So, they use that mandara for that churning. That mountain. And Vasuki is a snake. And that's a rope. And devatas on one side, asuras on the other side. And they churn like this. And that thing came up. So that, now Tulsidas ji writes here. Pema amiya mandaru biraha. Bharat's love is the nectar. Bharat's love is the nectar. Then, that Mount Mandara is his separation from Bhagwan Shri Ram. The pangs of separation from the Lord. Bharata Yupayodhi Gambhir. And Bharat himself is the very ocean of milk. Mati Pragateu Sura Sadhu Hita. And Raghubir. And Bhagwan, Bhagwan is churning now. You see, there were Devas and Asuras. Two of them churning. So Bhagwan has set in this world now the positive and negative. So Bharat's love on one side and Bharat's devotion and his sadhana and all the positive things, and then all the obstacles on the other side. And in his mind also, the obstacles of doubt and this and that, all the negative things, all the positive things. And Bhagwan made the world like that, and he churned Bharat. The Lord put it like this and churned Bharat, and out came the nectar of Bharat's love. And then, for who? Pragateu Sura Sadhu Hita. For the benefit of the gods and sadhus. So who will get the benefit of this Ramayana? Who will get the benefit of the Ramayana? Sadhu, actually. The person who has decided to turn his life from selfish existence into selfless existence. He's called a sadhu. Please see this meaning of sadhu. Tulsidasji is using, he says, Bhagwan Shri Ram did this for the benefit of gods and sadhus. Until we have turned our mind from selfish existence, from selfish living, to selfless living, we will not be sadhu. And if we are not sadhu, we will not get the benefit of this churning of this. Everybody has to become sadhu. Long ago, I used to feel a sadhu is somebody with a long beard, old man, and gray hair. In our village, there was a sadhu. We grew up calling him sadhu. We thought that was his name. He had a proper name. But sadhus. Why? In Sanskrit, the sadhu word comes from, see, it is explained like this. Para sadhnoti iti sadhu. Para sadhnoti iti sadhu means the one who does the work of others or who achieves things for others. That person is called as sadhu. It means whatever he is achieving in his life and his journey, he doesn't achieve for himself. He achieves for others. That person is called as sadhu. And that is translated in very simple language to mean a good man, a good person. That is one who we call a good person. Sadhu, in simple translation then, means a good person. In the old days, you know, when we say, nowadays in Hindi, when anybody does anything good or anything wonderful, people say, wah, 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 wah. In Trinidad language, what do we say? We don't have no equivalent for that in Trinidad language, isn't it? When somebody does something amazing, he say, wow. We say, way boy. Like that. Maybe that is the easiest Trini equivalent. You can't think of anything. Nowadays, the youngsters have a lot of nice phrases when they say, bad boy. Like that, eh? Something like that. And I think dread. Yeah. But in the old days, in the days of when Sanskrit was spoken language and all that, and in the scriptures, when somebody did something good, in Western societies, when somebody do something good, people clap. Isn't it? But in the old days, they never used to clap. They say, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. Like that. There are no wah, wah, wah and all that. The wah, wah thing is late. Sadhu, they used to say. This was the how do you call that? Exclamation. Sadhu. So who will get the benefit of the churning of the ocean? Sadhus. And who is a sadhu? The one who parasadnoti. Parasadnoti means achieving things for others. Whatever you achieve, whatever you do, that means selfless living. Selfless, not living for yourself. That means he's a good person, in simple language. So, see this. So Bhagwan did this for the benefit of the sadhu. It means to say, the person who is living selfishly and reading through this katha, reading through the Ramayana and going, and living a selfish life, it means he'll just read through. Have you found yourself just reading through there and nothing happens? Sometimes you read through and you don't know how much you've read also. But the one who will get the benefit is the one who turns his life into sadhu reva samantavya. Bhagavan Shri Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita in the 89th chapter, apichet sudurachara bhajate mamananya bhak. If that person is the worst and vilest of sinners, but he turns his mind and he worships me, it means he sees me in the world and worships me, works for me. Sadhu reva samantavya. He is immediately considered to be a sadhu. Samyak vyavasito hi saha. Because he has made a firm resolve in his mind to turn from the worldly existence to the divine existence. That moment he becomes sadhu. In chapter 9. So, the symbolism of Ramayana is given here itself. And this whole katha is what? Bhagwan Sri Ram churning the ocean of Bharat. And from that ocean of Bharat, what comes out? Bharat's love, which represents the amrit, the nectar of the ocean. So don't go far looking for symbolism of Ramayana. Just see Ramayana only. Tulsidashi continues. Bharat knows the pace of his heart has increased. Everybody is knowing now that Bhagwan Sri Ram is close by. They could feel it. They could feel the difference in the air, as it were. He says,
Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram. Bharat dikh Prabhu Ashram Pavan. Sakal sumangal sadanu suhavan.
Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram.
Karat pravesh mite dukh dava.
Shri Ram Jai Ram.
Janu jogi paramarthu pava. देखे भरत लखन प्रभु आगे
श्री राम जय राम
पूछे वचन कहत अनुरागे
श्री राम जय राम
शीस जटा कति मुनि पत बांधे
श्री राम जय
के हे कर सरु धनु कांधे
श्री राम जय राम
दे दी पर मुनि साधु समाजु
श्री राम जय राम
सी सहित राजत रघुराजु
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
बलकल वसन जटिल तनु श्यामा
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
जनु मुनि वेश कीन रति कामा
श्री राम जय
कर कमल निधनु सायक फेरत
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
जिय की जरनी हरत हसी हेरत
श्री राम जय राम
जय जय राम
श्यावर रामचंद्र की जय भरत दीख प्रभु आश्रम पावन And as they draw closer, Bhagwan, Bharat saw Bhagwan Sri Ram's ashram. From the distance, he saw the ashram. Sakala sumangala sadanu saha suhava. It was so beautiful. And as though it exuded vibrations of auspiciousness all around. Karata prabesa mite dukkata. And he entered the precincts of that ashram. From the distance, far away. He entered the precincts of that ashram. And Tulsidaji describes, Janu jogi paramara tu pava. And all his sorrows, all his tiredness, all things went away the moment he just entered the ashram. And it is as though some yogi found that absolute reality. And there itself. As though some yogi found absolute reality. It means he discovered himself. It was so wonderful. Dekhe Bharat Lakhana Prabhu aage. He saw Lakshman standing in front of Prabhu Shri Ram. And puche bacham. He was puche bachan means he was asking some questions to Bhagwan Shri Ram with lot of love. See, from distance he could see love. How you see love from distance? We feel love, na? Love we feel, but he could see love from distance. Kya baat hai? Kaise aankhe? How are his eyes? The eyes of a devotee is so well trained, you know. Because from inside, the eyes are being backed by something great. That is the idea. See, Sajata. Now he describes, Tulsidas describes what Bharat is seeing. See, Sajata. On his head, Kati Muni Pata Bimande. And on his waist, the clothing, on his body, the clothing of a sage, a Muni. Tuna Kase Karasirudanu Kande. His bow on his shoulder. And Bedi Paramuni Sadhu Samaju, and he's sitting on a Bedi. Bhagwan Shri Ram sitting. See, we grow up with certain words, and really we don't understand the meanings of the words and that kind of thing. So sometimes we're sitting on a Bedi. Bedi we know is the Bedi, you know. Bedi literally means an altar. This thing is also called a Bedi. It's an altar. It's called a Singhasan. It's also called a Bedi, and this is also called a Bedi, where the puja is done, because there you install the Lord. Here you install the Vyas. That is Vyas puja is done and all that. So you install the Vyas. So it's all, they all call a Bedi. It is called a Singhasan also. Bedi in Hindi, Vedi in Sanskrit. Vedi. So Bhagwan Shri Ram was sitting on a Bedi, and among so many sadhus, saints and sages who had gathered there, the Lord was sitting. Siya sahit rajat raghu raju. He was there along with Sitaji sitting. Balkal vasana. He was wearing the bark of a tree. Balkal. Valkal. That is Bhagwan Shri Ram's clothing while he was in the forest. He was wearing the bark of a tree. Valkal vasan. Valkal word means the bark of a tree. Jatil. Jatil means? Jata, bandne wala. One who has a jata. Jata is, in English there is no word for that. What is that? Ajura. Tie up your head in ajura. Tanusyaman is dark body. Bharat sees from outside. Janumuni besa keen rati kama. Both of them sitting there, it was like Rati and Kamadev. Bhagwan Shri, Rati and Kamadev means, Kamadev is the lord of love himself, and his wife's name is Rati. So the two of them sitting there shone like Rati and Kamadev means they are the very embodiment of beauty. Rati and Kamadev, they are the two most beautiful beings in the universe, beside Bhagwan. Rati and Kamadev. I mean, their beauty is bewitchingly, their beauty is bewitching. I mean, it will. But you don't know which is which thereafter. No? Karakamalani dhanusayaku pherata. And he was holding in his hand his bow and arrow and moving them up and down. Bhagavan Sri Ram is those itchy trigger finger. Bharat is seeing all of this thing. Huh? And he describes what Bharat sees, Bhagavan Sri Ram.
Satmanjo Muni Mandali Madhya Siya Raghu Chando Rama Madhya Siya Raghu Chando Jnan Sabhajanu Tanu Dhare Bhagati Sachidanandu Siya Var Ram Chandra Ki Jai Sharanam Umapati Mahadev Ki Jai Bhavan Sut Hanuman Ki Jai Bolo Bhai Sab Santan Ki Jai Siyavar Ram Chandra Ki Jai Sharanam.
These type of sceneries in Ramayana give the poet such wonderful field for expressing himself. The poet in Tulsidas he also says, Bhagwan Sri Ram and Sita ji, they were like bhakti and Satchidananda. These are the two goals that the two paths take us to. Na? The path of devotion takes us to the state of pure bhakti, amala bhakti, abheda bhakti. And the path of gyan takes us to Satchit Ananda. Tulsiraji describes Bhagwan Sri Ram, Sita sitting there through the eyes of Bharat. No, Bharat Singh. Ram, Sita were sitting there like bhakti and Satchidananda in the midst of all the sadhus who were gyan. Gyan, sabha, janu, tanu, dhari, bhagati, Satchidanandu. All the saints and sages were like gyan. And now,
सानुज सखा समेत मगन मन
जय जय राम
बिसरे हर्ष सोख सुख दुख गन
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
पाही ना कही पाही गोसाई
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
पाही नाथ कही पाही गोसाई
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
भूतल पर लकुत की ना चन सपे मला हन पहिचाने
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
करत प्रणाम भरत जिय जाने
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
बंजु सने सरस एहि ओरा
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
उत्साहिव से वाबस ठोरा
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
मिल न जाय नहीं
दशरथ बनाई
श्री राम
सुख विलखन मन की गति बनाई
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
रहे राखी से वापर भारू
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
चरी खेलारू
श्री राम जय राम जय जय
जय राम जय जय राम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
श्री राम जय राम
Sanuj Sakha Samet Magan Man along with Shatrughna Bharat from the distance seeing Bhagwan Shri Ram and Lakshmana Sitaji in front along with his brother Shatrughna both of them their mind went into ecstasy they lost as though all body consciousness bisare harsha soka dukha sukha dukha gana all sukh dukha everything went away from their mind and He fell, Bharat fell down on the ground, prostrate like a stick, Tulsidashi described. Pahi, Pahi, Prabhu. Oh Lord, save me. Oh Lord, accept me. I have come to you. He screamed out from where he was and fell down. And Lakshmana first saw him. Lakshmana heard. Bhagwan Shri Ram did not hear. He was occupied with the saints and sages there. Lakshmana heard. And Tulsidashi describes now try to describe the mind of Lakshmana. Bachana sa prema lakhana pahichane. He realized this voice has to be from Raghukul only. Ye mera bhai hai. Karat pranam Bharat jane. He knew it was his own brother Bharat. And Lakshmana had the pain in his heart from such a long time before of having thought bad things about Bharat. And now he could not wait to meet that Bharat. And Tulsidashi said, now his mind was torn whether to run there and embrace that Bharat or stay here and do seva to Bhagwan Shri Ram. Lakshman did not know what to do. Bandhu sraneh saras ehi ora on one side is love for his brother. Uta sahib seva basa jora. And on the other side, seva to Bhagwan Shri Ram. मिली ना जाए गदरत बनाई ही डिड नॉट नो व्हाट टू डू रहे राखी सेवा प्रभु भारू ही स्टेड ही डिसाइडेड टू स्टे एंड सर्व भगवान श्री राम एंड नॉट टू गो एंड ही शाउटेड आउट टू भगवान श्री राम प्रभु भरत इज कॉलिंग यू
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम कहत स प्रेम नाई मही माता भरत प्रणाम करत रघुनाथा उठे राम सुनि प्रेम अधीरा कहु पत कहु निशंग धनु तीरा श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
श्री राम जय जय राम
कहत स प्रेम नाई मही माता प्रभु भरत इज प्रोस्ट्रेटिंग टू यू फ्रॉम ओवर देयर ही हैज कम टू सी यू लॉर्ड भरत प्रणाम करत रघुनाथा प्लीज तुलसीदास जी इन द नेक्स्ट लाइन डजंट फाइंड वर्ड्स टू डिस्क्राइब उठे राम सुनि पेम अधीरा कहु पट कहु निशंग धनु तीरा एंड इन भगवान श्री राम sprung to his feet. And the description is, on one side went his valkal. The bark of the tree was weighing. One side went his valkal, another side his bow, another side his arrow, and another side his quiver. All things fell out. And in the next line, all we see is Bhagwan Shri Ram lifting Bharat and bringing him to his heart. All the people who witnessed this meeting between both of them lost all consciousness. Nobody knew what happened thereafter. In fact, none of the saints and the sages and none of the Ramayana tells how Bhagwan Shri Ram reached from where he was sitting to where Bharat was prostrating. It is as though he disappeared and appeared there. Whether he ran, whether he walked, whether he jumped, nobody knows. All the people lost consciousness that time in this meeting. Bhagwan Shri Ram brought Bharat to his heart, and the scripture describes, Bharavasa liye uthai ura lai kripa nidhan, Bharat Ram ki milan lakhi bisare sabhi apan. All lost their consciousness. And four things fell out when Bhagwan Shri Ram got up. Very important verse actually, so wonderful. We had seen earlier, very famous verse I had chanted for you.
अर्थन धर्मन काम रुचि गति न चाऊं निर्वाण यह वरदान न आन प्रभु यह वरदान न आन सिया वर राम चंद्र की जय शरणम उमापति महादेव की जय पवन सुत हनुमान की जय बोलो भाई सब संतन की जय सियावर राम चंद्र की जय शरणम
भरत प्रेत तो गंगा मैया मां अर्थन धर्म न काम रुचि आई Gati na chahu nirban. I don't want dharma, artha, kama, moksha. These four things I don't want. Char purushartha. Leave that. Janama janama. What is that? Janama janama rati ramapada yahad bardanana. And birth after birth, let me take. But let me have devotion for the feet of Bhagwan Shri Ram. So Bharat dropped four things. Dharma, artha, kama, moksha. Here Bhagwan drops four things. So many wonderful saints and sages have reflected on this verse again and again and again. Four things dropped out from the Lord when he got up. And some say, because Bharat had dropped the four purusharthas, these four things, Bhagwan also drops, you know. When we do things for the Lord, he responds also in like manner. Then some say, no, Bhagwan did not drop anything. These four, it is said that whatever is on the Lord, whatever is on his body, those things become jivit. Jivit means alive. They acquire life. And these four things thought, look at that. Bharat is the Lord's brother. He has been given the kingdom. And he relinquished that kingdom. And he has come here and he is prostrating at the feet of the Lord. Bharat is displaying such humility. And look at us. We are on his shoulder. We are on his body. Bharat is on the floor and we are on his body. They started thinking. So they dropped. Then Bharat is lucky. He's getting to touch the dust of the feet of the Lord. We are always on his body. We never get to touch the dust of the feet. So we also go down. All the bow and arrow and all started thinking like that. Because the Lord brings to life everything he comes in contact with. He is life itself. Like this, for so many reasons, saints and sages, these four things fell out. Other things, some say, he's going to meet the incarnation of love. Bhagwan is going to meet the incarnation of love. So why you need bow and arrow to meet love? Wherever there is love, there is no fighting. Most times. You're going to meet the incarnation of love. Why you go with weapons? You see? So for that reason, he dropped off those weapons, all things from his body like that. Then some people ask also, why did Valkal dropped out, you know? The bark of the tree, the clothing he was wearing. The Valkal represents sacrifice. The Valkal represents sacrifice. It is that the Valkal dropped out to touch the feet of Bharat because the Valkal thought that he was the incarnation of sacrifice. When he saw Bharat, when Valkal saw Bharat, Valkal thought, I am not really an incarnation of sacrifice, you know. Here is incarnation of sacrifice, Bharat. So the Valkal dropped out to touch Bharat's feet. And all of them, some sages say, dropped out to touch Bharat's feet. But Bhagwan Shri Ram brought him to his heart, and there was the meeting of the Lord's own love, which had become incarnate with the Lord's own self. What better meeting could there be between the Lord's own love incarnate and he himself? In that sort of thing, when the devotee develops such love for the Lord, that devotee loses his consciousness in this intoxicated form of devotion for Bhagwan. And that is why everybody lost their consciousness there. The devatas also did not know what to do. Everywhere, Bhagwan Shri Ram and Bharat met, the devata did not rain down flowers. Usually flowers come down, but everybody had lost all conscious. What flowers will rain now? While he was coming, they were raining down flowers. When he met Guha, they rained down flowers. But here he's meeting the Lord. And that means that in deep devotion, in intense devotion, the person merges with himself. One merges with him. See, in both cases, whether it is Gyan or whether it is devotion, now again the person merges and all consciousness is lost. It means it goes into Samadhi, whether through the path of Bhakti or through the path of Gyan. This brings us to the end of this Ram Bharat Milap, where these two great, great, great incarnations meet. Indeed, now what happens? Bharat is going to try to convince Bhagwan Shri Ram to go back to Ayodhya. This is a different katha. He tries. He doesn't succeed, of course. Bhagwan Shri Ram holds fast. Because Bhagwan Shri Ram was worried about this only. What he'll do? Bhagwan Shri Ram holds fast to his vow to come to the forest and stay for 14 years. But he takes his padukas and he gives it to Bharat. Bharat takes it on his head and goes all the way back to Ayodhya. There was a long, big sabha held there. All the saints, sages, they were there. Janakji Maharaj was there. Here, the two princes, Ram, Lakshman, all of them there also. And all the gurus were there, of all of them. And they held a sabha in the forest. This was the first sabha ever held in the forest. Sabha means what we call today as parliament. Parliament was held in the forest. That was a greenhouse. Not a red house. So, in that parliament was decided. Bhagwan said, no, okay, I accept the kingdom. What is it? I accept the kingdom. I am the king. Bhagwan accepted. But for the next 14 years, I will be here. You go back and rule for 14 years for me. And then Bharat requested that paduka. He took that paduka, took it on his throne and put it there and said, Bhagwan is the king. This is paduka. And he went outside in Nandigram. Built a little place outside the city and he stayed, and from there he ruled. Bharat dug a hole. Bharat dug a hole. And from down in that hole, he was ruling. He stayed down below. He thought, my Prabhu Shri Ram is in forest and he's walking on this bare ground. I cannot be above my Lord, you know. I have to be below my Lord. So below ground level, from there he ruled for 14 years. Below ground level he stayed. So he'll be under the feet of Bhagwan. Okay. That coming back also is so nice. But if I continue like this, I'll not stop. Ram Bharat Milap. The meeting of the incarnation of the Lord's own love with the Lord. One more point in this that Lord's love has incarnated fully in Bharat. That Lord's love is incarnated in all of our hearts also. Everybody's heart has a little bit of that Lord's love. Little tukura. And if we could go deep and find that little tukura, that little bit of the Lord's love in our heart, from there, we'll be able to discover His full love. We'll be able to discover Bharat in our own. That is His thread. If you could find His thread, you will find the thing that it is tied to. So that little bit of love is there in everybody's heart. We have to go on searching for it. Our problem right now is we take that love and we invest it in all the things of the... Not that we don't have love. We invest some love here, some love there, some love there. Yeah, some little bit of love we invest in all the things of the world. And therefore, we have lost the thread. Huh? But if we could go inside, collect all this fragmented rays of our love and bring it inside and invest it in Bhagwan, we'll be able to find the thread that connects directly to the Lord and be able to find Bharat. Bharat is not to be found outside. He's to be found in our own heart. He is the unlimited love, infinite love of the Lord manifest. Ram Bharat Milap can take place in our own heart. So historical thing aside, that was a historical thing. The relevance for us today is to find this thread in our own heart. And once again, connect. That will be Ram Bharat Milap in our heart. When we once again connect. We have this thread. Okay.